And that is why we have to make sure that every word, that's why Jesus, he said, man shall not live by bread alone, but every word. Don't take any word for granted. This one I'll take it serious, this one I won't take it serious. No. What are you sowing with? What are you building with? But also without faith, it is impossible to please God. If you are doing your business out of fear, you are not pleasing God. And the Bible says, when the ways of a man pleases the Lord, he will make even his enemies to be at peace with him. Amen.
Amen.
Somebody say faith.
Faith.
Love.
Love.
Peace.
Peace.
Trust in God.
Hope in God.
Materials. These are the things that we talk about every time. Amen.
Amen.
We say pray, worship, do this, fellowship, study the word. Those are materials of which you need to build. Amen. You need to begin to apply kingdom principles in your business. Apply kingdom principles in your family. Apply kingdom principles in your what? In your job or career. Apply kingdom principles. Speak the word. It says the Lord gave Daniel wisdom above all his contemporaries and above all his teachers. Speak the word. The word that you speak, they are spirit in their life. They control your atmosphere. They control your now and your future. So when we talk about living in the prophetic, declaring the word, doing this, praying, what we're discussing are the fabrics, the things that which by which you can build the foundation of your venture with. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to look at some things which are actually tied to the attitude, your attitude towards your building materials. Your attitude. Because a lot of times it's not what you do, but how you do it. Amen.
Amen.
If there will be profiting, if there will be a profit that will come from whatever you do, if profit will come out of it, it is the attitude. Your wise man once said, is here, your attitude will determine your altitude. How high you go will be determined by your what? Your attitude. Glory to God in the highest.
Amen.
Is somebody getting blessed this morning?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. I want us to look at 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 2 to 4. I'm just going to read because of time. It says, if I have the gift of prophecy and know all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. And if I give all my possessions to feed the poor, and if I surrender my body to be burned, but do not have love, those are activities, right? It says it profits me nothing. You see, can you see your profit in attached to your love? You see, the motive behind what you're doing. You see, when it is being motivated or being engineered by love, you see, profit will come out of it, because there is a kind of passion that will drive you that a normal driving force cannot withstand or cannot be compared with. Love took Jesus to the cross. Love made the Father to send his Son. Love. Somebody say, Lord, let your love consume me. Love. And looking at Hebrews chapter 4, verse 2, talk about faith factor. It's upon to us also, it hath been declared in a manner as unto them, but the word of hearing did not profit them. Can you see profiting again? Not being mixed with faith of those things that they had. Is the word being mixed with faith? The word is supposed to bring profit into your life, into your business, into your marriage, into every dimensions of your life. But if it's not mixed with faith, it won't bring what? Profit. You will make profit in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So considering those materials and so much more, which I will advise you to go back home and what study, what other materials do I need to build with? Considering all these, we need to now look at the attitude that we have towards all these things. How are we building? Because it is one thing for you to be given the cement, for you to be given the marble, for you to be given the wood and whatever that you need to build with, the iron rod and iron sheet and whatever. It is another thing for you to apply it rightly with the right attitude. We're going to look at something there. The first thing I want to talk about attitude is make sure that whatever it is that is the principle unto your profiting, make sure you do it regularly. Write it down. One of the problems that we have in the kingdom is that we don't practice these kingdom principles regularly. We do it once in a while. This week I pray, next week I don't pray. He says such will not bring profit. Do it regularly. I'm going to look at 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 15. These are practical principles. It says, meditate upon these things, give thyself wholly to them, that thy profiting may appear to all. Give yourself wholly to them, that thy profiting may appear unto all. Meditate on these things. What things? The principles, the ways of God. Meditate on them. He said, give yourself wholly. That is, commit yourself to them. Be diligent about carrying those things out. Amen. Be diligent about prayer. Pray regularly. The Lord gave me a word of wisdom about this thing, about being regular, about the things of the kingdom of God. He said, look at the heartbeat. The heartbeat that does not beat regularly. That's not regular. Heartbeat that's not regular. It's dangerous. And check the pulse. A pulse that's not what? That's not, it's not beating regularly. It's unhealthy. Check it out. There's such a thing called a defibrillator in the health world that they have to use, right, to normalize it. If the heart is not beating well, they have to normalize it. If not, that person can what? And back up. So you can imagine, when the heart of your prayer life is not beating regularly, how can it survive? It's going to get my point. If the heart of your sowing is not beating regularly, how can it bring profit? I saw Bible says sow in the morning, sow in the evening. That's what the Bible says. In fact, he went about to say that you don't know the one that will even bring forth for you, first. Just keep sowing. Someone that runs once in a while is not a runner. It's not an athlete. It has to become what? A lifestyle. You are not a sower. If you don't sow every time, you see somebody in need on the street, sow. You see somebody, every time the Holy Spirit opens your eyes and you have at least something. Don't say you don't have anything. You know, we talked about the issue of not having anything. Is it the one that said, the one that has nothing, it shall be taken from him? Mm-hmm. How can God take from someone that doesn't have? That means that person had, but he had the mentality, I don't have mentality. Mm-hmm. That's why God could take something from him now. So always say, even if it's this that I have, I will give. I will give. I will be a sower every time. Let it be what? Regular. When these things are not regular, in the morning I have faith. In the afternoon, faith is gone. In the night, faith comes again. It is what? Irregular. So that cannot bring what? Fruitfulness. Is somebody getting my point this morning? So it's almost, the moment we need to understand something is that the problem with a lot of people in the church is not, when I say the church, I'm talking about the body of Christ. Amen. It's not just that they don't know. A lot even know. But the problem is what they do with what they know. Quite a number of times, some people do nothing with it. They can preach it, but they can't do it. And more blessed is he that can what do than he that can preach. Amen. Doer of the word. So practice, do it what? Regularly. Thank you, Jesus. We give you glory. Can we look at different translations? The International Standard Version says, think of these things, devote your life to them. Devote your life to them so that everyone can see your progress. So another word for profit is what? Progress. Everyone can see your progress. The Holman Version said, practice these things. Be committed. Be committed to them so that your progress can be what? Evident to what? To all, including your health. I'm teaching you what I live. I'm teaching you what happens. I teach by experience a lot of times also, of course, let me use the word as the backbone of my experience, not by experience being the backbone of scripture, no. But I just use it to explain, amen. Got to a point I was checking my weight. I run sometimes on the treadmill, and then because of tiredness, because there will always be an excuse, a reason. It's about to get my point. Always a reason why you cannot keep doing it. I'm tired today, something. My mom told me, he said, look, you can't maintain a good shape this way. You run on treadmill this month till next week. You remember again, this treadmill is looking at me here. Oh, sorry. Let me get on treadmill again and start running. But when you do it what regularly, even it's gonna be every 5 a.m. you wake up and you run, or you maybe it's later in the evening, choose a time, plan it, and let it be what? Regular. Be committed to it. After all, it's your health and it's your life. Amen. Amen. Please let us apply the wisdom to every other aspect of our lives. Amen.
Amen.
We worship you, Lord. Can you look at Acts chapter 46? Acts chapter 2, verse 46 to 47. See something about walking on these principles regularly. He said, day by day, continuing.